In our previous video, we have created a web API and resolved the design problem of our API. So we have now two separate layers. One is our domain layer. It represents the complete structure of our domain entities. And another one is service layer. It represents the subset of our domain entities. We are using service layer to expose the data to our web API endpoints. In our controller class, we are exposing our service layer entity. And in order to do that, we have mapped the domain entities properties to our service entity properties manually. Here we have mapped only two properties, but this can be a very time consuming and a very boring task if we have to map 100 of properties manually. In such cases where we have to map the properties of like object A to object B and object B have the same name of members, Automapper works like a magic. We need very minimum one-time configuration to map any number of objects in our application, and it can save our ton of efforts in a big application. So let's go ahead and see how to use it. We need to install Automapper package first. We can install it using NuGet package manager or package manager console. Let's install using package manager console. Type install-package Automapper. It's installed. So it's a two-step process to configure Automapper. First, we need to create mapper configuration, which determines how two objects are mapped with each other. So define a variable named config equal new mapper configuration. And using lambda expression, mc goes to mc.createMap. And provides the source and destination types that we need to map. So here in our case, our source is model and destination is model resource. Create a new mapper object where mapper equals new mapper and pass config as parameter in this class. And use this object to map our list of models to the list of model resources. Where model resources, to get the list of models in this object, mapper.map and pass list of models as source type. And list of model resources as destination type. Here in method parameter, pass the object we need to map. So in our case, it is list of models that we already have fetched from DB here in model variable. Now we can comment this code. And let's put a breakpoint here. Run the application and access API endpoint. You can see our list of models have 5 models and all of those are successfully mapped here in our list of model resources object. Press continue. Perfect. Our list of models are returned perfectly using model resource object. So hope you understood the working of Automapper. This way is perfectly fine if you need to use Automapper only once in your application. But in case you need to use Automapper at multiple places for different types of objects, keeping this mapper configuration as controller class is not a good idea, because it will create a performance issue in our application. We should keep it in a separate class, and that class should be initialized at the time of application startup. So for .NET Core, Automapper provides a dependency injection extension. So we can use that extension to start Automapper as service in startup.cs. Let's see how we can do that. Add a new folder and name it mapping profiles. We can add mapping profiles in this folder. Add a new class and name it mapping profile. Add reference of Automapper. We derive this class from profile, which is defined under Automapper namespace. Add a constructor and create a map to map the source and target object that we already had done in our controller. we can copy this method and just paste it in our constructor. Control dot to add the namespaces for both of these classes. Now we can remove this configuration from controller. Also, we do not need to create a mapper object here in controller because we will get it using dependency injection from our startup class. Add a new read-only variable of type imapper. Just like DB context, we will get mapper using dependency injection. Set our local variable underscore mapper equals mapper and use it in our API endpoint. As this parameter is passed at the time of startup, we need to add Automapper dependency injection extension. We can add it using package manager console as we already have added Automapper and also from manage NuGet package interface. Let's use manage NuGet package interface this time. You can see installed component from install tab and Automapper is already installed. Click the browse tab and search Automapper dot and select this one. Click on project and here we get the list of available versions of this extension. At the time of creating this video, the latest version is 7. I recommend to use the same version to get the similar behavior we are seeing in this course, or you can choose the latest one. But in case it doesn't work, you will have to check the latest documentation from Automapper website. Press install button. Okay. Perfect, it's installed. And now we can use dependency injection in startup.cs and add Automapper as a service. So add Automapper and mapping profile namespace. Go to configure service method and inject the Automapper using service.addAutomapper. As a parameter here, we can pass the type of class. So if we will pass the type of mapping profile, our Automapper will scan all the classes derived from profile class and initialize the same at the time of application startup. Build the application. Great, it's successfully built. Here in our API endpoint, instead of getting model resources in a variable, we can directly return the same and delete this line. Let's put a breakpoint here in our profile class so that we can verify that this is called only at the startup of our application, and also put a breakpoint here and run the application. Call our API endpoint. See, our profile class is called at the time of startup. Press continue. And second, it stopped in our API method. Press continue. Perfect. Our model resource class is perfectly mapped from the model data and it is rendered as JSON in our browser. And if we call this API endpoint second time, see, our mapping profile is not called now, and controller directly moved to the API method. So this is how we can use Automapper to reduce a lot of manual mapping work with very minimum one-time configuration. In case we need to map more objects, we just need to create map in mapping profile class like this and use it using mapper.map anywhere in our project using single line of code. Hope you like it and please don't forget to press the like button and subscribe our channel to get the alerts for the videos we upload. Next, we are going to implement pagination for our model index page. Stay tuned. See you in next video.